Hello, my name is Oliver, and today I'm going to walk you through an initial Hello World project on your new Boss LS or HP machine. We're going to go ahead and start this video by opening up LaserWorks. Once I have LaserWorks open, I can go over and create a font. I can select this anywhere in on my page, and we're going to go ahead and highlight the existing text, and we're going to do a simple Hello World prompt. Here you see you've got various fonts to work with. We'll pick a simple one that everybody knows, Arial right here. You can adjust your height as well as your width, also with the ability to customize character spacing and line spacing. We'll leave all those at their default settings and click OK. And now you will see the Hello World text that we just brought up here. The next thing we want to do is adjust the power and speed settings. Our power and speed settings can be found over here in the upper right hand corner. We know that this layer is set to black, and that's going to adjust the Hello World color here. As you can see, the text color is black, so we know that's the black layer. If I wanted to change that, I would highlight my selection and select a new color, such as blue. And now we have blue text to go along with our blue layer. We'll go ahead and set this back to black. To change any power and speed settings, I want to double click on my layer, and it's going to open up my layer parameters window. Here we have speed, which is in millimeters per second, set to 400. That's going to be a good speed for this first engraving run for us. We have power. For this engraving, we want our minimum power and our maximum power to be equal. So we have them set to 40%. And we also have interval. Interval is similar to a DPI rating. We're going to settle with 0.09. That's also in millimeters. The lower that number, if I were to change that to 0.05, the more detail we're going to get, but the longer the job is going to take. The higher that number, such as if I went to 0.12, it's going to go quicker, but we're not going to have quite as much detail. For a basic text engraving, 0.09 is going to be a good value for us. So now that we've got all of those settings the way we would like them, I'm just going to go ahead and hit OK. At this point, now we can go ahead and send this file over to the machine. All I need to do to complete that is come over here to download. It's going to ask me what would I like to name the document. So we're just going to name this Hello. I'm going to click OK. And now we have file download success. So I can select OK. And from here, now we can go and move over to the machine and run our job. All right, so now we're going to move over to the machine and control the rest of this project from the keypad. With the keypad, we can control basic functions such as moving the head left, forward, right, and backwards. This is going to help us with lining up our project. The next step we're going to take before we actually run the project is focus. The LSHP machines are equipped with an autofocus function, and that is controlled from the keypad. By doing that, I'm going to select my ZU, move down, select the autofocus function, it's towards the bottom, select enter. Now it's going to raise my table until it makes contact with our autofocus probe, and then set itself back down. At this point, we are perfectly focused for our laser. We also have the option to use a manual focus, and I highly suggest this if this is the first time you're running a job, just to make sure that the calibration of the autofocus is still where it needs to be. To do that, you're going to have an acrylic rectangular shape in your white toolbox that came with the machine. And this simply hangs off of the bracket that came with, that is holding the autofocus in place. and kind of get a good angle here. As long as this L shape is going to hang right over the bracket and the bottom is going to be right snug on our material. So if that holds true, we know our autofocus is still calibrated correctly, and now we can move towards selecting the file. The keypad has the ability to store multiple files in there. We named our job Hello, so when I pull up the file manager, I'm going to look for the Hello title name. It also gives me a preview, so if I did forget what the name of my project was, I can see my preview, and here it's showing me Hello World as the preview. So I want to go ahead and select Enter on my keypad again to select that. The keypad is going to show me a larger preview of Hello World. I know it's going to be engraved because all of the text is filled in. At this point, we are ready to run our job. The last thing that we may want to do is line up our head to the appropriate position on our material where we want to engrave it. So this engraving, I just want to do in the upper middle portion of the wood. Now to set this as my new origin, I want to select origin on the keypad, and now I can select frame, which is going to outline where the engraving is going to take place. So now with the frame, it's going to do a small outline. As you can see, we have a pretty small engraving here. I'm going to scoot it up just a little bit, select origin again, frame one more time. Now that I'm happy with where that engraving is going to take place, the next step is just to hit start. So I'm going to go ahead and press start. Before we press start, we want to make sure that all of our external pieces of equipment are on and running. That includes the water chiller, the air pump, and the exhaust if you elect to hook up the exhaust system. So now that my air pump and my water chiller are turned on, I can hear the water chiller. I'm going to go ahead and close this lid while we operate the machine. There is a reed switch on the machine, so you will not be able to fire the laser if this lid is open. Now we are ready to go. I'm going to go ahead and press start, and here you will see the laser begin its engraving. This engraving is pretty short, it should only take a few moments. And now our job is completed, so it's safe to open up the door. I'm going to move my head back, and you can see our completed engraving of Hello World. Came out very nice, and that is our first job. This simple operation is going to be repeated for any job that you do, for downloading the files and running the autofocus function and setting up where you'd like to orientate your engraving. So now that you have a basic Hello World engraving completed, now you can move forward with some more complicated jobs. And if you have any further questions, please feel free to reach out to our technical support team and be more than happy to guide you with anything else you may need.